going to explain the third sub question of the main question 1. Here relation R in the set A, where A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and the relation R is equal to x, y such that y is divisible by x. Y is divisible by x. Means in ordered pair, y should be divisible by x. Such type of relation we have to take it. So, I drawn the set A here. Cross product if you are taking, many ordered pairs will be there. But I will show only the cross product which satisfy this condition. Here, if you are taking any element from here, that should be divisible by the element belongs to the domain. So, if I am selecting 1, 1 is divisible by 1. No any other ordered pair is there. If I am selecting 2, 2 is divisible by 1. 3 is divisible by 1. 4 is divisible by 1. 5 is divisible by 1. And 6 is divisible by 1. So, 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6. You can see a written here. Now, next. 2 is divisible by 2 also. So, 2, 2 is there in the relation. Now, 3 is divisible by 3. 4 is divisible by 4. 5 is divisible by 5. And 6 is divisible by 6. So, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 6, 6. That also written. Now, the next. 4 and 2. Here, 2, 4 if I am taking. 4 is divisible by 2. So, I can take 2, 4. 6 and 2. If I am taking 6, 6 is divisible by 2. So, 2, 6 I took. Similarly, 3, 6. 6 is divisible by 3. So, 3, 6. So, here these are the ordered pairs which satisfy the given condition. Now, we will check this is reflexive, symmetric and transitive or not. How to check the reflexive or not? First of all, you need to see the elements which belongs to set A. Set A, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, these are the elements. If 1 belongs to A, then 1, 1 should be there in the relation. Yes, it is there. 2 belongs to A, 2, 2 should be there. It is there. If 3 belongs to A, 3, 3 should be there. That is there in the relation. Like 4, 4 is there, 5, 5 is there, 6, 6 is there. So, the given relation is reflexive. Now, the next, we have to check whether it is symmetric or not. Now, see, 1, 2 belongs to the relation. If 1, 2 belongs to the relation, then 2, 1 should belong to the relation. But you can see here, no any 2, 1 is there. So, we got one of the ordered pair which not satisfying the condition. That is enough. So, we will write. Here 1, 2 belongs to the relation, but 2, 1 not belongs to the relation. Like if A, B belongs to the relation, B, A not belongs to the relation. If that is belongs to the relation, then only we can say that it is symmetric. But here it is not satisfying. So it is not symmetric. Now the next. 1, 1 belongs to the relation. Now, starting with 1 here. 1, 2 belongs to the relation. So, 1, 2 should be there. Yes, it is there. Like here, 1, 1 belongs to the relation. And starting with 1 here also it is there. 1, 3. 1, 3 is there. So, 1, 3 belongs to the relation. That is also there. Like, you can take any pair. Like, if I am taking 1, 5. 1, 5 belongs to the relation. Here it is ending with 5. So, we should see the ordered pair which starts with 5. Here it is there. So, 5, 5 belongs to the relation. 1, 5 belongs to the relation. 5, 5 belongs to the relation. 1, 5 belongs to the relation. And 5, 5 belongs to the relation. So, for transitive, what we need to see? 1, 5 is there or not. 1, 5. 1, 5 belongs to the relation. So it is transitive. I hope it is clear.
2, 3.
Now fourth sub question of the main question 1, exercise 1.1. The relation R in the set Z of all integers, R is equal to xy such that x minus y is an integer, where x belongs to Z and y belongs to Z. It means here, your domain and codomain. That is the collection of integers. It means negative numbers are also there. Negative numbers 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, positive numbers and 0. These two are the collection of integers. And which type of relation you should take? You should take a relation where x minus y is an integer. Means difference between the elements belongs to the domain and the codomain. That should be an integer. So, first of all, in A cross A, if you are taking A cross A, infinitely many ordered pairs will be there. Like minus 3, minus 2, minus 3, minus 1, minus 3, 0, minus 2, 2, minus 2, 3, minus 1, 4, like 1, minus 2, 2, 1, like infinitely many ordered pairs will be there. Now you take any ordered pair from the Cartesian product. For example, if I am taking 2, 0. If I am taking 2, 0. 2 is our x and y is 0. Then x minus y. X minus y means 2 minus 0. 2 minus 0 is 2, which is an integer. If I am taking any other ordered pair from the Cartesian product, if I am taking 3, 1. 3, 1. The difference between these two, 3 and 1, that is 2. Again, it is an integer. If I am taking minus 1 and 4, minus 1, 4, that is also an ordered pair from the Cartesian product. You can take as many ordered pairs from here. So, if I am taking minus 1, 4, minus 1, minus 4, that will be minus 5. That minus 5 is an integer. Like you take any ordered pair from the Cartesian product, then all those ordered pair will satisfy this condition. It means what? One by one we will see. Here it is very easy. It means if I am taking 1, first of all, reflexive relation we have to check. So, 1 belongs to the A, 1 belongs to A. If 1 belongs to A, then 1, 1 should be there in the relation. 1 belongs to A. 1 belongs to A. Is 1, 1 belongs to the relation? Yes, definitely. Because the difference between these two is an integer. 1 and 1, difference is 0, which is an integer. So, 1, 1 belongs to the relation. If I am taking 2, 2, 2, 2. 2 belongs to A and 2, 2 belongs to R. Because difference between 2 and 2 is 0, which is an integer. Like you can take any number, 5, 5, 5 belongs to relation. You take minus 99, then minus 99, minus 99, the ordered pair minus 99, minus 99 belongs to the relation because difference is 0. Like you take any ordered pair from here, any means the condition is there. For reflexive, you need to check here both x and y should be same. That type of elements you need to check. 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 6, 6, 10, 10, etc. The difference between 10 and 10, that is 0. 11 and 11, that is 0. It means the difference is again via an integer. So only that condition they told. X minus y is an integer. It means while taking the difference of x and y, we should get integer. So here, if we are taking any element from A, then suppose x I took, then x minus x is 0. 0 is an integer. It means for x belongs to A, x belongs to the relation. How we can say? For all x belongs to A, x belongs to the relation. Therefore, the given relation is reflexive. Next one, we have to check for x minus y and y minus x, because for checking the symmetric condition, if a b belongs to the relation, then b a should belongs to the relation. That was the condition. So here a b, you take one of the ordered pair 1 2. 1 2 belongs to a relation, because difference between 1 and 2, 1 minus 2, that is -1, that is an integer. Now take the reverse of that, 2 1, 2 minus 1, which is 1. 2 minus 1 is 1. That is also an integer. It means 1, 2 belongs to a relation. So 2, 1 belongs to a relation. Like you take any ordered pair. If I am taking 3, 2. 3, 2 belongs to the relation, because difference between 3, 2 to 3 minus 2. That is 1. 1 is an integer. Now you take 2, 3. Reverse of that. 2 minus 3, which is minus 1, that is also an integer. It means if 3, 2 belongs to a relation, 2, 3 also belongs to a relation. Like you take any ordered pair, that will satisfy the condition. So it is symmetric. Last one is transitive. What do you think? It will be transitive? Of course it is transitive. What is the reason? Difference between the integer is again an integer only. So, as many ordered pairs you take it. For example, I took 1, 2. Because we can take 1, 2, no? 1, 2. 1, 2 I took. Then, connecting with 2, I took 2, 3. If 1, 2 belongs to a relation and 2, 3 belongs to a relation, then 1, 3 should be there. Yes, 1, 3 is also there, because 1 minus 2 is minus 1, which is an integer. Here, 2 minus 3, that is minus 1, which is an integer. And 1 minus 3, which is minus 2, that is also an integer. Means here, all these are satisfying the condition of transitive. So here, we can say that the given relation is transitive. So in general, how we will be writing? You can take the elements as x, y and z. So first of all, you will show the difference between these two. Why we are showing the general case here? Because all the ordered pairs are satisfying the condition. So we cannot write all the ordered pairs here. Whenever the condition will satisfy, in such condition, try to write the general form. Because you cannot show all the ordered pairs which satisfy the condition. It is unlimited here. So in such case, go for the general. How you will be writing in general? You can take x, y first of all. Difference between x and y, that is definitely an integer. Now you can take y, z. With connecting with y, you have to take y, z. Difference between y and z, that is also an integer. Then definitely you can show that x minus z is also an integer. That only I written here. So it is transitive.